Maybe we'll call it poolside service. Hey, I'm Adam DePort, customer service expert, author, and speaker, and we're out here for the second video by the pool, and I don't know why I'm doing this, but it's just a nice day today, and maybe we'll call it poolside service. But we just got through talking about the Ritz-Carlton's $2,000 rule, and I wanted to talk a little bit deeper about employee empowerment. Because one of the things, when people talk about employee empowerment, they often don't know that there's a distinction between two types of empowerment. The first is actual empowerment, and the second is psychological empowerment. And they've actually studied this academically and found that there are differences between the two. So let's break them down a little and talk about what that means to you when you're managing customer-facing employees. First is actual empowerment, and that's what we traditionally think of when we talk about empowerment. That can be horizontal, it can be vertical. You're giving somebody more roles, more responsibilities, and a lot of times more power to do things than they had before. So they may get job horizontally, which that means they've gotten the powers of their colleagues. They may get it vertically, which means stuff that used to be a supervisor or a manager's role they can now do, and that may be approving a refund, that may be approving a credit, whatever it may be. So that's actual empowerment. That is giving them the authority to actually do more than they had before. Now, psychological empowerment's trickier. That is, do they feel empowered internally to use that authority? Are they actually going to take action? Once you give them the authority, do they feel empowered? And this comes down to culture in a lot of ways, because if you've had a command and control culture, if you have that traditional check and balance type culture, and I had that, one of the reasons I'm so big on empowerment is because I ran my small business that way when I first started out, over a decade ago now, but I changed and I started realizing how stupid it was to manage every little penny and how we were affecting customers. So I actually empowered the people. And I saw that it took a lot to get them to know they were empowered. It took a lot to let them feel that, hey, it doesn't matter what we used to do. Okay, if you give somebody a little too much or, don't do it quite the way we thought, we'll talk about it and we'll adjust for next time, but we're not going to eat your lunch for it. You are in safe. You are able to use this power without repercussion. So if you are transitioning and doing more empowerment, you need to realize that your team may not feel psychologically empowered. They may actually feel constrained or feel like, somebody's going to reprimand them or scold them. So realize the difference between actual and psychological empowerment and make sure you're taking both into consideration as you're empowering employees, as you're loosening up the reins and trying to shift the culture to more empowerment, whatever it may be. Know that the two types of empowerment are there and they work together, because without psychological empowerment, actual empowerment really won't do you a lot of good. All right, well, this is Adam DePorg, and you can find out more about me at customersatstick.com, and I will see you next time.